LMQ. Corki is the ban away. Vasilis, Caitlyn also removed out. We'll see if he gets the chance to play Lucian as well in this one, but these teams very much targeting their AD carries champion pool.
Right, so LMQ, immediately, they're just banning out what was just used by Cloud9 with success. So going with the most recent success here, I like that. Taking Corki off the field. And then Ziggs is always hard to deal with. If the enemy has Ziggs on their team, even if you're ahead, it's hard to close out that game.
Yeah.
And that's one of the places where, you know, LMQ could see comebacks from other teams.
Yeah, I mean, LMQ is a team that gets ahead early and then tries to siege and close it out by 25 minutes. That's their go-to sort of standard, is Caitlyn or Lucian, grab a Nidalee or Orianna in the mid lane, something with some range that can push people off turrets. And you get the wave clear and you're going to be okay with this one. So I like the ban away from the Ziggs. The Graves also dropped out, so three AD carry bans still here. Vasili, I mean, Graves is not one we've seen very much, but that's going to get removed.
Yeah, this is fun. I want to delve deeper into the AD carry pool here because we're getting, it's getting pretty shallow.
Yeah.
Already four bans. That's more AD carry bans than we've seen in a long time.
Yeah, so until the Lucian actually gets put up in there, it's not going to affect LMQ unless C9T is really trying to tunnel them onto a first pick Lucian and grab something else for themselves. Elise coming through, of course, Kha'Zix's still open. All the mid laners aside from Ziggs still open as well. And of course, both these guys, huge Nidalee players.
Yeah. Something I have noticed about LMQ is they ban out Evelynn a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Even if they are first pick, they really do not like playing against Evelynn, and they pretty much ban it all the time here. They are going to go with the first pick Kha'Zix, and it was a last ban AD carry, and they forego picking up that Lucian that you talked about.
Yeah, okay. So that's going to be interesting because that's just like the guy I'm thinking of. When I think Vasilia, it's just Lucian, Kate, Lucian, Kate, Lucian, Kate. There's a Lucian grab. Soraka picked up as well. Two big priority champions. So four AD carries banned and one picked. We'll see what this champion pool does.
Interesting. So Lee Sin hover over. Usually I'd jump on that and be like, oh, it's probably going to be jungle Lee Sin. But probably going to be top lane here, especially since they've already locked in the Kha'Zix. He did play top lane Lee Sin previously as well. So good combo there. But the Soraka already, feel like she's extremely strong right now. You have to need some sort of assassin like Yasuo or something in the mid lane to be able to take her out. Right now, with heals, the heal summoner being changed to remove ignites and giving the move speed, she's so much stronger than she used to be. Already when she used to have barrier, she was a bully in that mid lane. But now with heal, it's still hard to kill her, even if you do have an ignite, even if you do bring the jungler.
Yeah, so it really depends what their mid laner pick ends up being here, because jungle Kha'Zix has some decent ganks. There's enough pressure to follow through that maybe they can take him out. The other thing that kind of stretches to my mind right now is the fact that we haven't really seen the jungle pools tested here. So we're talking about guys getting banned out. Okay, it's going to be Ezreal for Vasili here, but also it means that Kess's Elise is going to be open and free if he wants to go for that. Or is he going to pick up maybe a Feral Flare jungle like Xin Zhao?
Yeah. I mean, Feral Flare, a little bit more late game oriented, so we'll have to see if they do that, because it does get thrown off a little bit by 2v1s. Don't get as much time to stack up your charges and get to the Feral upgrade later. But I'm still focused on this mid lane, what they're going to do about the Soraka, because you don't have to kill her. You can either do that, or you can go with something like Nidalee. And as long as Xiao Xiao is amazing at CSing under his turret, which he is, then you get past the point where it's hard for Soraka shoving him under the turret. And the Nidalee comes out huge in the late game. We've seen so many times.
Yeah, well, C9G, though, they don't look like the team that really wants to play hard engage anyway. It looks like more of a reactive defensive team. Soraka's in there. Morgana picked up as well. There's the Elisa's on top of that one. So even though they know it's pretty much guaranteed top lane Lee Sin, waiting a long time for Yazuki's pick up there, make sure they secure the rest of their lineup here, denying a support pick by grabbing Morgana.
Yeah, interesting. Because, as I said before, Yazuki, I always think of Shyvana when I think of Yazuki. Mm-hmm. So if it is going to be something of a counterpick to Lee Sin and something different, that would definitely be a new plan here, I think, from Cloud9.
Yeah, he was a long-time player of that champion. But no, it's actually Orianna in the mid lane matchup. Actually, this one is a good matchup in the lane for Orianna. Her reach is far enough with the ball that you can push back on Straka. So going for a laning phase there, plus Leona here for the support, so actually it's LMQ that have a lot of aggression, especially early on.
Yeah, they do have a long-range engage coming in here. I like the combo with Orianna and Kha'Zix as well, because he already is pretty tanky now with all the changes, and then he can easily get you into a good spot for a shockwave.
Yeah.
Talk about delivery systems. He is one of the best. Even if he's slightly in the wrong position, he can use his ulti for move speed buff and get somebody in there. So I do like the LMQ comp here, and I think it is going to be a pretty good early game for them, as you said.
So yeah, it looks like it's going to be the top lane Lee Sin. I don't see these guys swapping around much anymore. So Ezreal, you know, the AD carry pool is tested. Vasili going to have to play Ezreal in this one. Has played it before, actually still fits his style. Long ranged, Kaidi, pokey, has skill shots, whatnot. So, like, even with all those bans, he's not going to be far away from home.
I really like that combo, too. There's so much level 6 burst in this Leona plus Ezreal combo. It's something that St. Vicious was playing when he came in with Curse, you know, as a support, him and Cop. They didn't have a lot of time together, but they went back to this combo over and over and over because St. could just play sort of passively on it anyway until level 6. And then they have all this burst. They can make use of all the passive of everything and use that level 6 double ult combo to completely 100% one of their lane opponents.
And there's just so much burst with it. Actually, it's funny because this is a team that banned away Corki, who's like this big, like bursty AD carry, especially at 6. The Graves actually banned away by C9T. There's like a few of these guys who have this gigantic burst spike at 6 or, you know, around that level. And Ezreal, one that's kind of understated now. We see so much less of him, but he was one of the original sort of caster AD carries who can actually put a lot of magic damage burst out, win the lane before he's got any major damage output or any major damage items.
Yeah.
Also to point out, both these are going to be Trinity Force AD carries, so they're going to have their power spike fairly early on, but they're going to spike at 2 items compared to someone like Caitlyn or someone like Tristana, which we don't see much of anyway, but that they're going to really turn on about 23 minutes in, and you can see a game snowball off the BT Triforce completion.
Yeah. I love how it's just the standard first item for all AD carries is Bloodthirster now. That's a given. And you only have to worry about what is going to be the second one for the change here. Now, both supports starting out with the single ward. That's been very, very common because of the randomness that everyone's complaining about with ward trinkets starting at 2 minutes. Almost all the supports now are getting that extra gold, starting with at least one ward, so they can ward one of the buffs and then go for one of the invades.
Yeah. You know, it's interesting, actually, to continue a conversation. Actually, hold. Okay, I think everyone sees everyone, so they're going to back off. No, Ackman is going for it. All right. Looks like LMQ is going to push C9T out of the territory. No, they do see Moore, so they know that Moore has a ward. So depending on if they see him again, they can know when he puts it down. But C9T look for a bit of a re-engage. Damn it, into Xiaowei, Xiao's Orianna. They're just kind of firing while retreating right here, but looks like there will be ward control over C9T's red buff, and LMQ will back out.
I like this because C9T have no way of knowing if LMQ are staying in there or not. This is one of the tricks that we saw Lemon Dogs pull a long time ago, back when supports did start wards. You do the whole invade and recall from one of the bushes so that they have to be very wary of where the entire team is, even after them leaving.
Yeah, so LMQ, they're just going to move away to their standard lane assignments there. Looks like the whole pack is going to stay at the bottom lane. But that does pretty much guarantee AD support towards that side, with Ackerman holding teleport on Lee Sin, going to let himself get around the map. Looks like the same thing here for Cloud9 Tempest. They'll protect their blue buff. That's going to be safe, though. Their ward used defensively. LMQ actually will get spotted here.
They're going to go for the invade regardless.
Ooh. He can actually tell by the fact that the little lizard's attacked that C9T was in that brush. So he just backs out. He can go for his own red buff. And of course, teleports top. Sees, okay, that's where they started. Blue buff start, no big deal with the ward coverage. So yeah, one of the things I was going to talk about in the pregame, if I remember properly, yeah. So one of the things that changes now, because a lot of these supports are starting with one ward, is they're basically got two less potions, which actually increases the value of poke supports. It's easier to remove the support by poking them out of the lane. And I'm wondering, like, I know we're still seeing Karma fairly often now anyway, and a bit of Lulu support as well, these two big poke supports, but that's a relative increase in power for them.
Yeah, not only that, but also with the changes to the lifesteal runes, AD carries have a lot less sustain here too. So exchanges in the bottom lane have become a lot more important. But it also means that if you take any sort of damage, you have to worry about all-ins from champions like Leona.
You do. It's actually interesting. I was informed that Vasili is actually running lifesteal quints anyway in this one, even though it's a pretty significant damage drop to not run something like attack speed quints. He's still going for like the old school build. Armor seals, lifesteal quints. Can just sustain up in this lane. Because, hey, Morgana might puddle him. And things like that'll happen. He'll take damage from Lucian.
And they're very happy that they did get the level 2 shove here with the Leona lane using the execute. And as you said, since he's running lifesteal runes, he'll be able to sustain, keep up this siege at the turret, and test Altec's ability to CS under his turret.
Well, so far it's 19-8, so I gotta say, the early lead definitely going LMQ's favor. Up in the top lane, Yazgi versus Ackerman, 15-15, basically.
So Altec not doing really that well on the test then, huh?
No. He's getting 50%, basically. That's an F.
That is definitely an F.
All right. 12.
They might call in some jungle support there, though. Elise does like to do the white camp fairly often. Easy rotation could be made down bottom, but it looks like he will do hard farm, and more attention going to be paid to mid. Something that a lot of mid laners, with all the 2-versus-1 swaps, they haven't been paying as much attention to early jungle ganks.
On the flash jump, there's Cocoon on the backside. Noni taking a whole bunch of damage down to 100 health. He stays and goes down. The trade kill back to Bijou, though. Kez looks like he's going to stay around for this one. Damage in a Xiao Wei Xiao. The kill did go to the LMQ mid laner, but first blood to C9T.
And it is going to be a renewal of double buffs here for Kez. So the only thing really that we have to remember is that Xiao Wei Xiao still has his flash, whereas Bishu has no summoners at all now. And he was only able to pick up one ward, so he can't ward both sides himself. Might see repeat ganks in the middle.
Yeah, we'll see what plays out with this one. So far, just level 4 top laners, though. These guys, I guess it is a bit of a lead for Ackerman. The early pushing is working out. His teleport's on cooldown for one more wave, but that's going to leave him exposed to Kez right now. He has Safeguard. He has flash.
He still has his health. He still has his health potion as well. Probably want to start chugging that one as soon as he sees the gank coming. Should start chugging his health potion.
Yeah, well, he's safe. He flashed the cocoon though. Now, when will the safeguard come up? He does not have a trinket, but he does have the Q to the double golem. Trinket's coming up in about 10 seconds. Ackerman's still playing the jungle.
Interesting route he chose to go on here, because now it's going to be very difficult for him to get out alive.
Well, he's buying a lot of time though. Yazgi's going to spot him out. The slow comes through as well. Kez will eventually make his way over to Ackerman. 3 seconds on the safeguard. Still running around through the ward. And he's gonna teleport back to the top lane. Cocoon doesn't reach. Ackerman outplays the gank.
That was so close to him catching
Vasily really close to death though. One summoner he'll use flashing away from the range. Ignite onto Altec. He's burning low. He's gonna lifesteal a little bit off some minions. Get the 3 health from Butcher. And these Xiao Wei Xiao Bishu a bit of a trade. No name showing back up, but Kez already here. Level 5 on Elise. The cocoon, the bind, it's gonna catch Altec. Doesn't even matter. Kill picked up there for more. LMQ in the bottom lane.
Alright, and that was even before level 6 here. So yeah. Vasily's going to hit level 6 before Altec. It's gonna be a very, very uphill battle. All 4 summoner spells down for Cloud9 Tempest in the bottom lane. I would expect some more action down there if LMQ have their say in it.
I mean, yeah, they're 52-33 in minions. You're going to have a gigantic item lead for Vasily here. I mean, he's got, what, 200, 400 extra gold from minions, plus another 150 for the assist. Like, he's not far from BF Sword right now. He's basically a wave away from getting to recall and hit this. It actually might be this time right here. And that's going to be another big bully lead. I mean, there is an AD ratio on his ultimate. Yeah, 1700 gold. He's going to have that, plus potions. At level 6, he's going to have a really good all-in.
So even though the level 1 invade from LMQ, they didn't get much done with it, the AD and support did help with the blue for Cloud9 Tempest, and they stay there a bit longer. So Ezreal Neona got to go to the lane first, start shoving it, and kind of snowball that early lead.
Yeah. It worked really well for him, honestly. They're continuing to push to the edge. Actually, Phage is the item picked up there for Vasily, not BS or not really Bloodthirster, most likely. But a lot of extra mana from the Sapphire Crystal. We'll see if that pays out. Kez does hit level 6 at a pretty good clip. 26 minions on him. Does have the, for what it's worth, rank 2 ultimate available on Elise. So he's farming well, but that's kind of the only lane that's going swimmingly now for Cloud9 Tempest is just their jungler. He's got to salvage these lanes.
Going to be difficult for him, but it looks like he's going to go contest the second blue, second red, does have the timer on it, and just by dropping a ward, scares No Name off of his own red buff.
Going to be enough for him for now. Ackerman, though, look at this. Already he's trying to steal away the red buff. He's going to get spotted out by Yazuki, but not sure if it's going to matter too much. Has safeguard available. Jumps over really safely. Looks like, by the way, for the Lee Sin, 2 points W, 2 points E. So he's splitting the points between Safeguard and Tempest. just to keep that in mind. Xiaowei Xiao is actually maxing Command Dissonance on Orianna. I know some mid laners max attack. Former mid laner for TPA Toys used to. The Q, but Xiaowei Xiao is going with the W in this one. He's doing the standard thing, taking Harass. As per normal, I'm pretty sure he's maxing the Star Call. You can see the damage pretty decent there.
I think the most interesting thing about this game so far was that the level 1. Because a lot of the LCS teams that we've been talking to were complaining about being on red side, oh, we always have to go for an invade when we're on red side because we're so scared of the blue team doing an invade on our red side and there's no way of knowing it. But Cloud9 Tempest, they defended their blue instead. They didn't go for an invade.
Yeah.
And it was LMQ that were able to get that bottom lane shove because of it. And now the bottom lane is probably the biggest point of power
Flash
for them.
Goon lands on Ackerman, though, and he gets executed. I love that. The Dragon ulti guaranteed no safeguard or anything for Lee Sin. Dodged it, like, pushed him into the cocoon. That was really awesome coordination.
All right, so yeah, bottom lane is the power for LMQ. Top lane looks like it might be the point here for Cloud9 Tempest that they want to rely on. That actually caught him up in CS as well. So Yuzuki was able to catch back up by shoving the lane after.
Yeah, definitely a big lead.
Ackerman's going to have to do his use his teleport. Up to the turret, though. Mm-hmm. Very popular summoner spell now.
And it's going to be Tiamat versus the makings of Sunfire here. So Yazuki not rushing the damage build. Just going to weather the storm against Ackerman. It's pretty much par for the course. LMQ did try their all-in right around level 6, but with the reaction time of Glebe Glarba, he managed to spell shield the Q stun, and that allowed Altec to dodge the ulti out from Ezreal. But No Name waiting in the wings. C9T, they've got to be careful. They are pretty much in gank range.
So what they want to do right now, LMQ, is get the black shield down, then they can use Solar Flare.
But here comes Elise. There's a teleport as well. Of course, Yazuki has his, but Ackerman does not. More flash, but he's still in range. Stun's going to come down. Yazuki finds a kill, some good damage from Kez. No Name forced to ulti away. Good fight for C9T. And will they dragon or will they turret?
Probably go for the dragon here. It's hard to even take the turret because there will be two people defending. Now, this is what happens when you go to the source of the global. Cloud9 Tempest, their jungler, Kez, ganks up top lane, makes them, not only do they get a successful gank, but also burns the global threat of that teleport by going to the source of it. And then that allows, his gank up top allows a gank down bottom by Yuzuki, giving them the dragon. The question is, though, is that enough time for Ackerman to get the top turret? Looks like it will be an answer. So it's not like a huge objective gain for Cloud9 Tempest.
Yeah.
Just a trade.
Yeah, just the plus one kill. Otherwise, the trade, that turret's going to be gone. We'll see which team can use the fact this turret is dead for an advantage. Looks like Yazuki will look for a bit of a flank on Lee Sin. Shocker's going to land on a Bishu, down to half HP. Damage took him for Xiaowei Xiao. He does not look for another trade. But gets the health bar a bit low, and once again, Soraka forced the last hit under turret, down 20 CS.
Both junglers going to be called in there, too. All right, here's the combo.
Good damage comes through. Altec a bit low on health. The flash in from Vasili. Can he get the rest of his damage? Glebe tries to block the Q. Looks like he will, but the ulti comes in. Altec flashes, keeps alive. Glebe Glarbu a bit low. More. Keeps stoning him away. Binding won't land. Still, that summoner spell's burned.
Bottom lane, they're going to retain control as well. CS going to remain in their favor. Will they shove it down? Yes, they're not trying to freeze it at all. Going to try and get that turret down. That would be two outer turrets, and they could start putting up wards in the jungle, start counter-jungling, get to that mid-game power that they really like.
Well, Dragon form comes across. Ackerman a bit under fire right here. Yazuki looking for the attention with this one. Nice jump in by Kez. Keeps him in range despite the kickback. Now the flash is going to dodge the cocoon. Ackerman is safe, but loses the summoner. Another fight in the mid lane. That Bishu taking some good damage. Xiaowei Xiao staying for this one. He does have Ignite up. Doesn't go for the all-in.
Plus, he's almost 30 CS up on Bishu in the mid lane. So Xiaowei Xiao, again, showing his dominance in the mid lane.
Ulti comes in for more. The dive in towards Bishu. He flashed away, keeps himself alive more. Now rooted up underneath the turret, has almost nowhere to go. Oh my gosh, the Morgana ulti comes by. More is going to go down. Bishu with the kill credit. LMQ bit off more than they could chew.
Yeah, overextension right there in between the turrets. They thought they could get the Soraka. Best champion at baiting.
Yeah.
Probably. In the game.
Three heals and the flash, the black shield also helping with that one. That's a team with multiple supports, and you can see why that's effective. Stop the dives rather successfully. That's multiple now great ultis by Glebe Glarbu. manage to not steal the kills away and going actually towards a, what I believe is a... This is actually a player who rushed Spooky Ghosts many times in Morgana, so we might see Twin Shadows come out.
Interesting. A lot of different choices with Morgana. Uh-oh. Vasilla's going to chase him off that pink ward. But yeah, Morgana, so many options with the support Morgana. A lot of times it's very hard to get two Azanias, so many of them will even forego getting that item ever and just try and get the normal support items like the Crucible and like the Auras to help out their team. But if you can get it towards that late game, she performs a very similar role to what a mid lane Morgana would do. You can get most of the effectiveness out of it.
Yeah.
Well, we'll see where the build is going with this one. One thing I guess to keep in mind with mid versus support Morgana is that support Morgana actually maxes Black Shield second. And I believe that's actually the last skill to max for mid Morgana back in the day. So I guess you can kind of consider the difference in AP, the difference in skill order. And you can see damage now going into Vasili though, down very low. Force a dump back with his ult take, though with the ulti in, it's going to get locked a little bit, and he's going to turn off the ultimate to get the last few attacks in. That's going to be a kill picked up. Moore is going to be running away from this one. Kez late to the party, but kill for C9T.
This is one of the reasons why we talked about Bishu and Altec being the 2 points for Cloud9 Tempest you have to be really worried about.
And it's working. You even got Kez, though. I think everyone on C9T that was stepping up around these players, those two had the best series yesterday, but I gotta say, I think everyone's putting in really good work right now. Bottom lane turret's going to be going down. C9T equalized that score. They're up the dragon. No name looks for the engage here. The jump in. He's going to get the shotgun if he wants it. There's no flash available. The silence. The shotgun comes in anyway, though, for Bishu. He tries to heal himself. Not going to be enough. Xiaowei Xiao gets the kill credit. Great assassination right there.
Yeah, that's that invisible ball delivery system that we talk about in Champion Select. Works great for ganks, too. Don't have to wait for team fights. Ah, double effectiveness out of that one. Get the minions as well as stop all techs back.
Absolutely. He didn't let more or less hit that. He had a charge. Didn't even go for it. Scumbag Vasili.
That's money down the drain there, too.
Yeah. Just taxing his support for no reason. All right, gets a melee minion. Not as bad, but could have been better. Mid lane still under fire. Kez forced to hold this lane. I gotta say, despite the fact that C9T holds a gold lead, LMQ are still finding places to make moves. The dives mid... everywhere.
It's about to be answered right here with Vasili's bottom turret.
True.
So it's pretty much the even game moving towards the mid game here. Altec has been able to complete his Bloodthirster. Most important item, 4 AD carries. Vasili actually rushing for that Trinity Force first. Not even going first item Bloodthirster here.
Well, that was his build. He actually went Lifesteal Quince. And with that, if you go Lifesteal Quince, you can give that build up. And that's actually one thing. That I want to see if AD carries actually move on towards is if you have sustain somewhere else, can you rush Ayad? It's a big DPS increase if you can, or just a non-bloodthirster item in general. But yeah, Triforce done now, 16 and a half minutes in, pretty quick clip for him. Bloodthirster, of course, already done and stacking up here for Altec. We'll see how these items continue to scale. We'll see where their builds end up taking them soon. C19 on top of Ward's Cocoon lands on a no-name, good Dark Binding as well, but he leaps over the wall safely. He's going to be all right with this one.
Those wards are very, very popular nowadays because of the picks that you can get standing in that river. So many people walk over this little bridge right here by the Wraith Camp. So it's probably the most popular spot for picking people off.
Yeah, and some damage on the Moor. The jump out of Noname, not a big deal, unfortunately, for them. All take down on a duel with Vasili, but remember, Triforce is done. It's going to be some big damage for Ezreal. Jumps forward. They're trying to trade blows back and forth. The
Soraka.
Wish coming by as well. So many heals. In comes the jump, the flash, I believe, the spell shield, everything. Leave Glarbu gets the kill on that one, but double summoners burn from Morgana.
Oh, AD carries with all the heals, and Bishu adds his from the mid lane. There's the teleport from Yuzuki. Trying to time this one with Dragon. I guess that solo kill. The dual down bottom is going to turn into an objective, and they'll have to send somebody back immediately after they take the dragon. Oh, Noname wants the steal!
He pops the ult, he's buying time, flashes out, can't get back in. Nice attempt.
So he makes him drop the pink ward, though.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, they're going to need to send somebody back as quickly as possible to defend that top turret. Ackerman, with his Tiamat, is shoving very quickly. This is actually the same build that he runs on Renekton. Tiamat into defensive items straight after.
Yeah. I think it's the right way to do it, though. I feel like Hydra is often really greedy.
Mm-hmm.
And especially with someone like Lee Sin or Renekton, where you've got sustain in your kit, you don't need the extra lifesteal necessarily. Going to see Yazuki forcing Ackerman away. Goes to Dragon Form, though. Flash and Kick are available. Yazuki's in front. Meaning the Kick won't send him the right way. The Flash Kick comes in, keeping Ackerman safe. Like he's Guile.
Like that little move. Yeah, so talking about the build again, the Cowl is really important against Shyvana.
Mm-hmm.
Because she does so much magic damage. She has not gone with the Blade of the Ruined King early. So she's almost all magic damage. And they're little ticks of magic damage. So
yeah,
you get that regen all the time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the regen I feel like is super understated on Spectre's Cowl, but it's such a good landing item.
Yeah.
Against magic damage.
Because she's not, Shyvana's a magic damage champion, but she's not a burst magic damage champion.
Not really, no. Not so much. It's going to be a lot of consistent damage output there. The wave clear, the pushing much better now for Vishu's Soraka there, without a blue buff for now, but you know, again, he talked about it in the pregame video. He never got a blue buff in their finals in Spring 2, but here they're having a much better time at this one. The jungle under control. Another blue goes to Vishu, speak of the devil. He's having a pretty good time. He's still down 50 minions, to be fair. I gotta say, Xia Wei Xiao's putting on a clinic with CS, but this is a player who often takes wraiths, who's gonna get a big lead because of that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the two matchups that we highlighted, the Xia Wei Xiao mid versus Vishu and then the bottom one, have been extremely exciting here because there was a lot of attention paid mid with junglers. And then meanwhile, down bottom, we just saw Altec and Vasili dueling it out. And the victor gets the dragon for that one, too.
Wow, some pretty big damage on Ezreal's Silence prevents the Arcane Shift away, but he's going to go back for the poke right here. Relies on his support to keep himself safe. Looks like Vasili shows no fear. Of course, no other rotations are noted. Just going to be the teams walking back into the back lines to hold onto the mid lane. Some more good poke. Binding's going to be dodged. More poke coming in. Vasili, honestly, just constantly looking for damage.
Now, Soraka is going to enable Cloud9 Tempest for the to siege a bit longer here, though. You can see Vasili got chunked out, and even though Xia Wei Xiao has shields that he will have to use reactively, there's no way to sustain Vasili without letting him go lifesteal off something. So the extended siege from Cloud9 is going to come in on the mid turret, and they can slowly whittle it down.
Yeah, it begins. Bloodthirster, Lucian, pretty much fully stacked by this point for sure. Down to half HP. Binding lands on a more cocoon as well.
Oh!
Big damage comes through. Can't cast a spell. But a three-man shockwave might just answer. Ezreal comes by. Yazuki is safe. Wish used just in case by Soraka. There's Ackerman on the wings. Kez a bit low. Has to flash away from Nonin, losing even more health though. He's got to run away. Vasili finds the shutdown, but the kill back on a Nonin. Cleave Larbu does not stay around too long. Ackerman does get stunned. Vasili now on the run away. He's going to allow the team to disengage. Red buff slow is actually rather effective. Gonna put some damage on C9T on the way back. Ackerman now to counter back towards the mid lane, and LMQ actually rewarded with the mid lane turret.
Yeah, that was a great shockwave from Xia Wei Xiao to get the momentum back in their
Summer
favor,
heal
but
used, keeps Cleave alive, but they find a kill back. They're still going for it. Xia Wei Xiao, now forced to run, does not have flash. Ackerman in the back lines, Beach with the heal, keeps himself alive. Ackerman ward jumps to safety. 3-for-1. For a turret for LMQ.
Was that an arcane shift forward into the face of danger?
Yes,
from
it was.
Silly.
He
got a Glee binding to the face.
Yeah. That was a little bit silly. Guess he picked that name for a reason.
I was hoping you'd go that direction.
Yeah,
all right.
Worry. You got me with sheep. You got me with silly. What else you got? You
got
more?
Let's take a look at it again. Because more actually is going to get a binding again here a little bit later. But yeah, the silly arcane shifts straightforward into the binding from Glebe. He was almost able to burst him down.
Mm-hmm.
Got him very, very low, but not quite. Ackerman in the duel with Soraka has to run away after he sees the armor buff on her.
Ackerman now
again,
in danger.
Again, has to run away.
Cocoon, but a great two-man kick. Gonna dash to a mini. Repel's coming up. Kez still chasing. Red buff on Yazuki, but he's not in range for that just yet. Some damage comes through. In comes Nonin for the counterattack. Q is big damage, though. It's gonna force C9T to give respect.
All right, so mid-game getting pretty exciting here. Next dragon fight, 1 minute 20 seconds. We will have both teleports for it. Last time, we didn't really get to see the team fight around dragon because of the duel between the AD carries. So if never mind, he's going to keep on arcane shifting forward. So
no fear.
That might happen once again.
Yeah, the Soraka armor buff is enough to keep taking too much damage. Vasili actually going for Ruin King on his Ezreal. Interesting, another slight variation of the builds there. It's actually some pretty good poke power. Very kiteable. He's very self-reliant with a build like this. Can get away from most threats in the front line. So Yazuki will have a very hard time dealing with him. If we get to that stage in team fights where he's got to deal with him by himself. Sweeper used to hold the mid lane and take stock of this game. We're 23 minutes in. C9T, the underdogs of this matchup by a lot. Mm-hmm. LMQ's only lost a single game in the Challenger Series, let alone a best of three or best of five. But C9T holding a 2,000 gold lead so far into the mid game.
The thing about C19's comp, though, they rely pretty heavily on the skill shots landing for their hard CC. They don't have any guaranteed hard CC going for them. But the bindings have been on point, the cocoons have been on point, so it doesn't matter.
Gonna find no name for this one. Can they keep him in the danger? They will. He's gonna get stunned up, but he's still stealth. Now Kez getting the engage, losing most of his health. I don't know if he has anywhere to go. Ignite is on 7. Heal comes by. The Solar Flare hits, but so does the Wish. Altec in a battle with the Vasili. Kill goes through to Kez, but the kill back for Altec. Gets the assist thanks to the Wish, of course, on that one. But a 1-for-1 on the map.
So up top, up in mid, it was Kez who went down eventually. So this time around, we saw the AD carry duel right before Dragon. Mm-hmm. Again, Altec comes out on top, but the jungle is down, so they can't take it. No smite available.
Vasili, despite the lane lead early on, 1-4-1 in this game. Teleport comes in for Lee Sin. Actually, the same for Shyvana. Both teams saying, hey, you know, Dragon's up. 4v4 for this. Jungler's back alive. AD care for LMQ back alive. Here we go.
Yeah, Altec is definitely having the advantage in the 1v1 duels. However, they're not truly 1v1 because a lot of the times he's getting Soraka heals. There's extra heals coming in. Not quite a fair fight between the two.
That's how you play the globals, man. They just stick around and say, hey, press R at some point.
He wants to go for the steal again here? No, not going to be able to.
Just a blind Q. Wasn't even the jungler.
Yeah, exactly.
Wanted the 112 damage he'd get out of that one. It's probably rank 1 Q. It's a standard build for top lane, Lee Sin. Blue buff once again to Bishu. I don't think he's lost one all game, actually, so.
No, he hasn't lost blue buff. However, Xiao Xiao is just destroying him in CS here. Already completed the death cap. Yeah. So high impact shockwaves aplenty here for LMQ. Mm-hmm. Unfortunate for them that they won't get that fight around Dragon, because they really have a pretty strong team fight. I mean, everybody is very mobile, so they can really kind of close Cloud9 in. And then if they save Shockwave for a very good Shockwave mid fight, then they can clean up pretty easily, even though they are behind in gold.
Yeah, when you speak about gold, I want to touch on items real quick, because the basically Elise core is done now for Kez. Sorcery's Haunting Guys, Ancient Golem. So this is pretty much the squishiest point for Elise right now, where this is right before she starts actually building real tank items. So you talk about a mid-fight Shockwave cleaning things up. We've seen how fast Kez dies when he gets caught out here. So it's going to be a bit of a battle for Elise about, you know, how well she can get the damage in versus getting caught out. Start of the game, 2-0-1 is now 3-2-1.
So he does have to been play pretty careful. That's one of the drawbacks of going with that penetration build that you mentioned. He's got a lot of damage for burst damage.
Oh, wow. Moore's getting destroyed right now by Baron.
Those skill shots there.
Dark
from
Binding
Cloud
Cocoon.
Tempest.
Yeah.
Landing
he's
over
off the map.
And over. But yeah, what was I talking about?
Elise being very squishy, risky build.
Oh, yeah. He's got so... his burst is really strong because of it right now. But he is very squishy in return, so he'd much rather be picking people off, going for small fights, small duels, where he can burst someone out and make them play more defensive rather than have to build more tank.
Yeah, well, see if they can find this one. Rylaze is done. Going to be a Randuin soon for Bishu. Of course, LMQ, very physical damage heavy. They'll get some from Orianna, a little bit from Leona.
Oh yeah, they'll get a lot from Orianna here. Xiaowei Xiao's got the trifecta for mid laners already. 27 minutes in, and he's got the three main items that you want.
Yeah.
So he's got plenty of magic damage coming from LMQ.
You can see 330 minions by 27 minutes. I actually wanted to see when the 300 mark was. I didn't quite track that, but that had to be like 25, 24 minutes in. That's a pretty quick clip.
And it's not like it's costing No Name a lot of CS either.
Yeah.
So.
You see, like, no one in CS really suffering this game.
Can't really blame him for stealing away jungle camps. All right, the vision is pretty equal here too, so this game definitely more balanced than the scoreboard says. Vasili does dodge one binding, but he doesn't dodge the cocoon.
Oh, Oh man, he goes right down. The Mikaelis didn't actually catch him in time. This one, the re-engage, though, Gleave forced to flash away. C19, they're gonna find him binding onto more. The engage comes in. The support, though, to tank him. Flash over the wall, though. In comes Yatsuki and Kez. Big damage comes through. Ren with popped as well. Two kills so far in the fight. Two-man shockwave, oh, gigantic from Xiao Wei Xiao. Can LMQ get any back up? Looks like not. Two, three, four kills now in the fight for Cloud9 Tempest. 14-5. Ackerman, the only one alive. He's gonna force back. C19, look for Baron.
This could very easily be Baron for them. It's gonna have to be a miracle move from Ackerman. He doesn't even want to go for it, though. Great job here by Cloud9 Tempest. I have to say, though, it is in large part due to Vasily's missteps. He can make up for it all right here, though. No.
It was about as well timed as it could be.
Pretty good shot.
Way to respawn.
Yeah, but Vasily's been playing very dangerously
yeah.
and getting burned for it time after time again. He's going full Lomo Nation style here. He gets caught up by the entire three-man combo there from Cloud9 Tempest, and that's going to be a one-team fight for them.
Solar Flare whiff too. The bottom lane actually of LMQ in general.
Yeah, it was basically a great black shield there from Gleave Glarbu as well to turn this one around. And then Yuzuki coming in. Even though the shockwave is gigantic, Bisou's there with the heals. Keeps everyone up long enough for Altec to come.
Yeah, the heal from Soraka there clutch to keep Yazuki alive in that fight. And you know, to talk about this, C19 spent, oh god, Vasily. He's in a bad spot.
Vasily, please, no!
Cocoon, he's down. C19 spent all three bans and then grabbed Lucian first rotation.
Yeah.
Attacked Vasily's champion pool very hard. And on Ezreal, champion who's supposed to be very safe, who's building safe with Triforce Ruin King,
he's
not having a good
he's
show.
He's going with the Wound style, arcane shift in forward, but he didn't build the Randuin's like Wound does.
Yeah. He's or not, play Graves.
He's not tanky.
No, he is not. So it's going to be some damage now to mid lane turret number two, 29 minutes. CNT hold on to a commanding 9,000 gold lead. They now push into back toward the inhibitor turret as well. Teleport comes in from Ackerman. He just gets exploded at the very start. Way too greedy on the TP. LMQ losing a lot of kills.
Yeah, they're going to get this inhibitor turret already.
The overextension, though, they get one kill back. The turret falls down. They'll see if any more kills come across. No, just a 2-0. The heals from Soraka keeping the team alive. C19 refused to go down here.
All right, they've got the inhibitor. Great move. Another arcane shift forward. He's got to be careful. Altec wants to make him pay.
He's got the shield, lands a Q. Dark bonding for fun. Yep.
You know,
wow. Yeah, culling.
Vasily, please. All right.
Wow.
So you mentioned how many bans there were against Vasily. And then they also took away Lucian early.
Yeah.
You got to wonder, how long has it been since he has played Ezreal?
Dunno. Season 3?
Yeah, probably. Maybe too long is the answer here. No name, jumping right in, trying to get off the combo, but they get the turret and they claim the bug life. Able to get the inhibitor off of the back of this one, too. They get another kill here? No.
Yeah. Go to grab the first two. Nearly got Vasily. So, Yazuki, 507 on Shyvana. Pipe to play, pretty tanky overall. Stops at just the Cutlass. That's enough tracking for him.
If I was LMQ, I'd probably target Yuzuki, like I said, with the bans, just because I haven't really seen people put pressure on his pool to see what else he has to pull out.
Yes.
But I really do like this matchup, though. Yuzuki actually changed his name on live to Lomo Nation.
Yes,
he did. Because that's Vasily's one-liner right there.
Yeah.
And I really like Lomo Nation specifically just because it sounds like what the fans of LMQ would call themselves. Like, Raider fans from the Bay Area are like
Raider Nation.
Lomo Nation is like the hashtag that all the LMQ fans would use when they make good plays.
Are 49er fans gold diggers? Probably not.
No.
I'm from the Bay Area. I don't even know what Niners fans call themselves.
All right. Well, Lomo Nation gets himself out alive. Yuzuki escapes and affords his team top lane pressure. Able to get down one turret and should probably be able to roll into two pretty easily here.
Yep.
Map control is definitely going to collapse very quickly for LMQ. C9T going to start putting up more wards as well.
Looks like the contest now for the inhibitor turret top lane. Yazuki happy to chill on the complete opposite side of the map of his team. It's like, you know, you
Whoa!
Playing full Vasilia style. Go in and Glebe Glabber down the front lines. Puts the ulti down to a massive, massive shockwave. But the wish keeps the team alive. The fight still goes on. More is going to lose all of his HP. The fight's still going on. Kez the front lines. He's a bit tankier now as well with the Rand to his Omen. Kez has to run away. Ackerman about to go down. Altec finds another kill for himself. He's now dominating 6-1 and 7 on him. Inhibitor under fire. Another 2-0.
Wow. LQ. Trying to end it in style, though, there. That was Vasili going full Lomo Nation. Trying to draw them in, and it kind of worked, grouping them up for the Shockwave and then Ezreal ulti, but
wow,
not quite.
1v2. No, Vasili finally gets a kill with the offensive Arcane Shift, the teleport in, the flash from Yasuke. That's going to be enough for him. That's going to be another inhibitor going down now. Now the push in for the Nexus turret's going to be big damage coming through. Looks like the team's going to be enough. Xiao Wei Xiao alone to defend. Not going to have much of a chance here. Down he goes. Now more here for the defense. There are still two Nexus turrets up. It's the slow grind without an AD carry trying to kill these off. The minions likely to be enough. Turret number two going down in Cloud9 Tempest in the grand final best of five. Take the second game ever off LMQ.
All right, yeah, come out with the strategy. They